Am I the asshole for refusing to do a DNA test? My dad found out my mom was cheating and she won't say with who or when, but we know it's likely around the time she was on a stay-at-home mother thing, as she had all of us, two brothers, one sister, around the same time, so any one of us could not be my father's. He's divorcing my mother and wants us to take a DNA test to prove we're his children, otherwise he isn't paying for college for us. He promised to do so before this and all of us have been counting on it. My sister, oldest, did the test because she was confident she was related to our dad. She was likely pre-cheating and she looks the most like him, so I was pretty she was. She's also in college and is relying on our dad, and he's going to keep paying because of the results of the paternity test came back positive. I have a feeling I'm not my dad's biological kid since I don't look anything like him, and people even have commented I don't look like the rest of my family. I'm terrified because I think he's upset enough that he won't talk to me anymore and definitely won't be paying for my college. I don't want to take the paternity test because I don't want to know, but if I don't, I probably won't get college paid for. The money isn't in a college fund but set aside as investments my dad has and isn't going to my mom in the divorce proceedings probably. I don't know how things will go and I'm starting college in September. I stupidly picked a pretty expensive school because I thought my dad would pay for it and he said it was okay, but now even if my mom was willing to, I don't think she can afford it. I'm so mad at her and my dad for putting me in this position. I've told him I'm not doing the test and he said that's okay, but he will assume I'm not his and not have anything else to do with me once since I'm 18 already. I'm living with my mom but not talking to her because of this. Edit. After reading some of the comments, I've decided to do the test. I didn't want to out of fear, but now it's clear it doesn't really matter and it's better I know for sure. So you're 18 and just found out your dad may not be your dad, and he's punishing you for something beyond your control. Not the asshole. Your mother is clearly an asshole. Your dad is being an asshole to treat you as a stranger if you're not getting a DNA test. Edit. Thanks for the awards, we've got a lot of kind strangers about. Not the asshole. Your parents suck. I'd have the DNA test done personally just to find out, and if you aren't your dad's, try to figure out who your biodad is. It will help later down the line if your doctors ever have any hereditary health questions. You don't have to now for sure, but I eventually would once I came to terms with it. I am so sorry you are going through this. That is so shitty to deal with as a 17 or 18 year old kid. Go to the college you think will be best for your future. I funded my own college. My parents didn't pay a dime. You can do it. It's harder, but you are capable. Oh hun, course you're not the asshole, but what are you gaining by not taking it? Is there anyone you can talk to? Your dad is being awful. I can't imagine being willing to walk away from my child. And you are his child, whatever a blood test says. Not the asshole. This is what I would say to my dad in this situation. Dad, you are my dad. You've been with me through my entire life, and everything that has happened to me. The fact that your pain and anger at my mother makes you willing to give me up, willing to give up our relationship, and the fact that you've been my dad for my entire life, and willing to abandon me is destroying me. Everything that you're feeling with mom is so valid and worthy. But why would you do this to me? Think for a minute whether it's worth destroying me because you're mad at mom. This isn't even about college. This is about the father you've known your entire life abandoning you cause he's hurt and pissed. What the hell? Your dad is a huge asshole. He's just gonna cut you off after being your dad for the past 18 years? I get the hurt of finding out your wife cheated, but that doesn't mean he should take it out on you. I'm sorry you're stuck in this situation. Probably the best thing to do would be to see if you can apply to a cheaper school or defer your application for a year. If he will not be funding, then you should prepare for that. Also start applying for scholarships. Edit. Not the asshole. But you parents are both assholes. Not the asshole. Ask your dad if the last 18 years of raising you meant nothing. Ask him if he is willing to hate your mother more than he loves you. You have had one father your whole life. Does he really want to throw that away? If I was in your shoes, I would likely be looking into legal options as well. Not sure if you can force him to pay. In some states, a promise is a legally binding contract. Edit. Never mind. Not the asshole. Your mom's an asshole for obvious reasons. Your dad is also an asshole because I can't see how he can raise a child from birth and then be so cavalier about abandoning and disowning them for something that isn't even their fault. It's genuinely horrifying to me that he can apparently turn his love off that quickly. If it were me, I'm not sure the results of the DNA test would matter. I'd never be able to forgive my dad for having such an easy time turning his back on someone he raised and used to love. Not the asshole. However, you should ask him, if he is serious. Take the test anyway, there might be serious DNA and medical history you need to know. If he is not your father and some other guy is, you will need to find out if he has genetic markers for cancer or other diseases. Your mom is the asshole for cheating without protection. Has your brother taken one? Your father raised you, he is furious with your mother. Talk to him before taking the test and ask him if he really will punish you like this. Get the test. Do it for you, not for him. If you are the son of another, track him down and maybe he will pay for college since he had 18 years free from child support payments. Am I the asshole for uninviting my cousins from my wedding for feeding info to my mom? I, 28M, am an only child. When I was 12, my parents divorced when my dad found out my mom cheated on him. This was devastating to my dad. My parents were best friends and started dating when they were 17. I played sports and my dad was my coach, so I had a much closer relationship to him than my mom. I was supposed to spend 1 week at my mom's, then the next week at my dad's. But I would usually just lock myself in my room at my mom's. Usually my dad would drop me off and I would get on my bike and ride the couple miles back to his house. My mom would ask me things and I would literally pretend like she didn't exist. It got so bad that lawyers got involved thinking my dad was turning me against my mom. My dad encouraged me to spend time with my mom, but I couldn't. My mom tried putting us in therapy, but I would just sit there till the time was up, not saying a word to her. Eventually my mom broke down and let me just live with my dad. I haven't spoken a word to my mom in 15 years. She would show up to my games alone. Sometimes I would ask my dad to tell her to leave. Sometimes I didn't even notice she was there. She would try talking to me after and I would walk right past her. I cut her whole family off besides a few of my cousins that were around my age. She showed up to my high school graduation and I asked a couple teachers to remove her and they did. She never dated anyone else to my knowledge and was still attempting to reconcile with my dad a few years before he passed. Calling it the biggest mistake of her life and begging my dad to forgive her. When my dad passed a couple years ago, she tried to show up to the funeral and I met her outside to ask her to leave. My fiancé Rachel was with me when I did this and my mom cried upon learning we were engaged. Rachel introduced herself as my fiancé, saying she couldn't believe I hated her still this many years later. So last week I received a letter from my mom with a large check inside. In the letter she said she couldn't live knowing she wouldn't be invited to her only child's wedding. That her whole family is hurt that I cut them off. And that she had been keeping tabs on me all these years through my cousin's updates out of respect for me, but couldn't handle not being at the wedding. I ripped the check up and sent it back to the return address. She shouldn't have even known my address as I keep her blocked on all social media. I called up my cousins who admitted that since I was 14 they have been providing my mom with updates on me. Prom pics, college updates, engagement photos, and they sent her my address. I was so mad that I told them they wouldn't be invited to the wedding anymore because I don't want my mom getting access to it. Rachel is saying I'm going too far now and uninviting my cousins along with freezing out my mom's whole family because of her actions is an asshole move. Am I the asshole? Edit. The cheating was with a teammate's dad. This was highly embarrassing for me and caused me to have to move towns. Caused me to lose friends. I'm going to go out on a limb and say you are the asshole. Acting out as a 12 years old is to be expected. Deciding not to ever forgive your mom is totally your right, though it was 16 years ago, and you, while affected, were not really the aggrieved party. The fact that you are still throwing tantrums like a 12-year-old, at the age of 28, makes you the awe. Edit. I'd even go so far as to say your fiancé should consider this a pretty serious red flag. The fact that you can act with such hatred and spite over something that happened over 16 years ago, and only peripherally involved you, to me shows a pretty serious character flaw. At the very least, she should be concerned about what it would take for you to direct that anger at her, and what form that anger would take. Go to therapy and unpack this shit. This is a pathological level of hatred unless your mom literally told you to your face she regretted ever having you with your dad and kicked your dog as part of the divorce. I don't think people have to let go of anger and forgive every single slight, but you weren't even the one cheated on and it sounds like she tried to do everything right by you? I don't think Am I the Asshole is the right place for this. Please consider going to therapy, it sounds you have a lot of pain bottled up. Wishing you all the best. Maybe unpopular opinion, but you are the asshole. Why are you punishing your mom so severely? She made an awful mistake years ago, a mistake many parents do. They have a right to their own lives and moral failings. Honestly, I would encourage you to explore why you feel this hatred for your mom that seems disproportionate. Punishing your cousins for showing compassion does seem like going too far. I honestly don't know what to put apart from if having an affair was literally the only thing your mom did and she was cut off from everything. I feel for her immensely. How someone parents is not measured by their relationship with this spouse. This is so complex and upsetting. Goes to make cup of tea. Honestly, I think keeping up this much anger for so many years is hurting you just as much as it is your mom. You are the asshole for what you are doing to yourself. This doesn't honor your dad, by the way. You don't have to invite them to the wedding if you don't want. But if your fiancé is telling you you're going too far, maybe hear her out. Not the asshole, I guess, but I don't like it. Fuck it. You are the asshole. Shoulda just committed to it in the first place. Disproportionate response to the cousins. Oof, this is a tough one to judge on the exact question you're asking. I'm not seeing that you asked your cousins not to talk to her, so I'm feeling you are the asshole here. You certainly have the right to be angry at your mother, but holding such an intense grudge for this long over her cheating on your father once just doesn't sit right. This is something you need to actually deal with. Honestly, your mother doesn't sound like that bad of a person. Yes, she made a horrible mistake, but she spent 15 years passionately trying to have some form of a relationship with you while doing everything she can to respect your boundaries. And you gave her nothing for that. If there's more that your mother did wrong, I'd understand, but it's just not there. Am I the asshole for telling my girlfriend that she should have her imaginary boyfriend cook her dinner? My girlfriend loves to read and she gets really involved with the books she is reading and she usually rants and raves about them. It was never a problem, but about 3 months ago, she started to read a lot of romance novels. This happens at least twice a week. She has started to project things onto me. For instance, if she is mad at someone in the book, she gets mad at me. Some days, she will tell me to not speak to her and criticize me, and I would be wondering what I did wrong and try to talk to her, and she will just leave the room. The next day, she will sheepishly tell me that she had been mad about something that happened in the book. She also sometimes gets mad at me and points out something really romantic the lead may have done for the woman, and she gets upset at me for not being that romantic. This is easier to deal with as I just have to be romantic and smooth talk her a bit, which I love to do anyway. Having to figure if it is a real issue or just her being angry about a book is hard, and she gets even more annoyed if I ask her if it is about the book. I have been just ignoring it because I never thought it would be a huge issue. I had a horrible day at work and I was pretty crushed and exhausted. I greeted her and she ignored me, and I asked her if she was actually mad at me or if she was sulking about a book. She told me to fuck off. I wanted to tell her how bad it had been, but I really couldn't after she dismissed me like that. I did, and I decided to just rest and play games as I was really tired and didn't want to cook. I ordered food for us and I was gaming when she asked me if I was making dinner, and I told her I was too tired to cook and hard ordered food. She loves to eat home-cooked food and is not a fan of eating out in general, and she called me lazy. I snapped that maybe one of her imaginary boyfriend could cook for her because I was too tired to do it. She refused to eat the food I delivered and she went to bed hungry, and I feel like such an asshole right now. I feel terrible that I upset her, and I know that I should have dealt with this maturely and not tried to insult her. Not the asshole. That's super unhealthy of her. She's basically living vicariously through the characters in the book and making it your responsibility to navigate handling her mood swings over it. I love to read and I've gotten super emotional over characters, but I've never expected real life to mirror fiction or blame someone else for what happened in the story. That's just taking it too far. Not the asshole. Your girlfriend needs to see a mental health professional. She is not okay. What she is doing to you is not okay. It is abusive. Not the asshole, but some type of intervention is going to need to be done. Letting this continue is not going to be healthy for either of you. Not the asshole for the little quip, but you are the asshole to yourself if you stay with this girl. I had to reread this when you mentioned getting home from work, because up until then I was certain this girl was around 14. This is no way for a grown woman to behave. Get out while the getting is good and do it fast. You don't want to know what a crazy person is capable of when faced with the prospect of rejection. Why did she go to bed hungry? If your girlfriend can read a romance novel, she can read a cookbook and follow the step-by-step instructions to prepare a meal or make toast. Not the asshole. People in books are written to be idolized, specifically romantic leads. You can't compare to someone written and designed to be perfect, someone polished, and someone who can have their actions changed with a backspace key. She's holding you to an impossible standard. Maybe turn the table on her and see if she'd appreciate it, like tell her that she's not being the perfect girlfriend by romance movie standards. You are not even remotely the asshole here. I know plenty of people, myself included, who read as a way of disassociating, but never should anyone in the right mental state treat anyone like this over a book. Everyone also has days they don't want to cook. If she wanted a home-cooked meal instead of an ordered one, she could have fully prepared herself one. It's on her she went to bed hungry. I feel like your response is a little rude, yes, but understandable if she is constantly doing this to you. I would sit her down and have a serious discussion about her getting professional help for her behavior, because nobody deserves to be in a relationship with someone like that at all. If she isn't willing, for your own well-being, I think it would be best to part ways. Not the asshole. This is like a worse version of your girlfriend having a dream of you doing something wrong and then gets mad at you for it the next day. This is also like when guys watch movies and erroneously buy into Hollywood's fantasy that you get the girl in the end by being her friend for years and you eventually fall in love, but I guess the girl version with books instead. Point being, she is too deep in La La Land and needs to get back into reality and stop comparing her relationship to an idealized one she reads in a fictional book. Am I the asshole for yelling at a boy who opened the changing room curtain while I was changing? I feel like it should be obvious, but I was kind of made out to be the bad one in the situation. I was at the shopping center a few days ago and wanted to try on some clothes I had picked out. The changing rooms weren't the solid doors you could shut and lock, but the sliding curtains. I purposely went to the last changing room since it wasn't occupied and I wanted as much privacy as possible. I did notice a woman and her son, who was running around the store and messing around. But neither one of them at that point were in the changing room area. Anyway, I had gone into a changing room and tried on several different things before getting ready to get back into my own clothes. I could hear the boy being loud and messing around and I assumed he was close by, but quite literally I was not expecting him to open the curtain to the changing room while I was in and run away. I was too surprised at that moment and he already left before I could say anything, but he came back and pulled the curtain back open, and I yelled at him to go away and stop messing around. Apparently he had started crying, and when I left the changing room his mother was waiting by the entrance to the changing room. She confronted me and told me that I was incredibly disrespectful to her son and there was no reason for me to yell at him. I told her that there wouldn't be an issue if she would just be a good parent and take control of her son. Another woman who worked at the store came by and said that I made a scene out of something that wasn't a big deal. Personally, I felt violated because I was in the middle of changing and even though her son doesn't know better I felt the need to tell him to stop and it's his mother's responsibility to parent him. Am I the asshole? Edit. My reaction wasn't to intentionally yell but I was irritated and it was a reaction from surprise. Edit 2. I don't think some people are understanding that I yelled because I was startled, not to be mean. Not the asshole. But the woman working at the store? WTF? She should have validated you or at least not tried to gaslight you. Not a big deal to her, sure, because it was not her privacy. It was her customer's privacy she should have helped protect. Of course your privacy is a big deal to you. SMH. Edit. Okay, thanks everyone for giving me a finer definition of gaslighting. Yes, I agree it gets overused and I'm guilty as charged for using the wrong term. I guess it's Darvo then, is it? But we're in agreement that whatever the store employee did was not okay. Not the asshole. People have to learn how to control their kids. Not the asshole. I'm sorry. Who is disrespectful of whom? 1. It's mom's job to keep kid out of trouble in public. If mom can't do that, mom shouldn't take kid public places. 2. Kid knows what the curtain's for. Kid threw it open because kid thought it'd be funny. Kid is clearly not ready to be in public. 3. Mom underplayed kid's actions because you yelled. That's not a sign of responsibility. Not the asshole. You were in a designated private area. Half dressed or naked. His mother not only wasn't controlling her kid but had the audacity to tell you off. Seriously, it doesn't matter if he's 5 or 15. Good parenting would have included her keeping her son in check, meaning in range of eyesight and hearing. Parents can be so lax and expect complete strangers to babysit their kids or just give them a pass cause their kids. 1. We area not in a designated kids area as in a playground, daycare or school. 2. Changing rooms like bathrooms a deserve respect. Three kids with shit parents have shit manners and they all need to be told off when trying to shift blame. Not the asshole. He disrespected you by harassing you multiple times. The mom needs to discipline her son better and teach him right from wrong. Shame on them. Not the asshole. If my son was running around opening occupied changing room, he'd get a stern verbal lesson and have to apologize to the people he disturbed. Your reaction was completely legitimate and justified. Not the asshole. At all. Shitty kids need to be called out if their parents suck. NTA, maybe she should parent her kid instead of standing around looking for a fight.